Hi, welcome. In this video, we're going to talk about Cauchy sequence and move on in proof as to how a particular sequence can be called a Cauchy sequence. So let's start by looking at the Cauchy sequence. So a sequence, so let's take this particular one. So this is a sequence. So we say this particular sequence is a Cauchy sequence if for any given epsilon, so given epsilon greater than zero, then there exists n which belongs to the set of natural numbers, and such that for all nm greater than n, we are having this sequence is less than epsilon. So basically, for Cauchy sequence, given any epsilon greater than zero, so we have all this. Now, we want to prove whether a particular here is n. Yeah, so we want to prove whether a particular sequence is Cauchy or not. So let's do that proof. Yeah. But now this particular proof is premised on the fact that every convergent sequence or every Cauchy sequence is convergent. Right, so let's take the sequence, this particular sequence, and if it is converging, so let's assume that this one converges to a certain real number a. So if it converges to a certain real number a, it means that the limit of this particular sequence as n approaches infinity is equal to a. So when it's got to this, then we have the equivalent statement. So the equivalent statement of this is to say that given epsilon positive, then we're going to have a certain n belonging to the set of natural numbers. Alright, so that for all mn which is greater than n, then we're going to have the absolute of the difference of these two sequences being less than epsilon. So we're trying to prove something of this nature. Alright, but it is premised on the fact that any given sequence which is convergent can be referred to as a Cauchy sequence. Alright, so let's continue from here. Now I realize that for this particular one, given that this is the case, then we also have alright, so we have so we have the sequence minus 8 limits being less than epsilon over 2. Alright, so given this condition, so given the condition that mn is greater than n, then we also have another sequence n and minus a, that's the same limit, being less than epsilon divided by 2. Alright, good. So it implies that, so what we are actually proving is this. So when we put this here, we have the absolute of this minus that of n, and this will be equal to, so for this particular one, by definition, we are getting something of this nature. So we're going to have this minus that, then realize that we have minus sign here. So minus, then minus, that will come here. So that this one by definition is leading us to this sequence minus the limit. Okay. So we have this sequence minus a. So we have all this. And this will be equal to wherever the sequence minus the limit. So this, the negative here affects this and that. And we'll be having minus this sequence plus A. Alright, so we have something like this.
Good.
Alright, so from here we can rewrite this particular one. So now we have this minus E. Alright, so we also have A minus A. Now we want to apply the triangle inequality at this point. So by application of triangle inequality, obviously by triangle inequality, it means that we're going to have all this. So all of this is going to be less than or equal to we have this minus E, then plus, so we have the A minus this particular sequence. Now we realize that this one, as it is here, is taking the form as it was here originally. So we say that this can be represented by epsilon divided by 2. Now, but if you look at this one, its nature doesn't correspond to what we have here. So to achieve that, we negate what theory we have in the absolute symbol. So that we say that what we have here is still the same as saying this particular sequence minus its limit, m plus. So negating whatever is here results in, so the sequence then minus its limit. So at this point, it is appropriate that we use the epsilon divided by 2 in place of this. But if you look at that, it is less than, so it means this is going to be less than. So in place of it, we have epsilon divided by 2, then plus epsilon over 2. Alright, so epsilon divided by 2, so when we add, we're going to have this to be less than epsilon. So once we'll be able to show that this particular sequence here, so the if you subtract this particular from this, eventually we are getting it to be less than epsilon, then we have proven that the given sequence is a Cauchy sequence. I hope you found this one helpful. I'll catch you in the next video where we look at more examples. Thank you very much.